Sunmi Hwang is one of South Korea's best-selling authors whose books cross boundaries between children's literature, modern fable, philosophical tale, and eco-aware nature writing. She lives in Seoul, where I had the pleasure of meeting her last month. Born in 1963, she studied creative writing, and since she made her literary debut in 1995, has published more than 40 books. Her most famous work, The Hen Who Dreamed She Could Fly, was first published in 2000 and remained on bestseller lists for 10 years. It is now part of the school curriculum in South Korea and has been translated into at least 18 languages, though perhaps more by the end of the book fair, and selling more than 2 million copies worldwide. The English translation by Chi Young Kim was published last year by Penguin USA and by One World in the UK last month, and an anime adaptation, Leafy, A Hen into the Wild, made box office history with more than 2.2 million viewers as the highest grossing Korean animation ever. It was released in the UK last month. The Hen Who Dreamed She Could Fly is a farmyard fable for all ages with echoes from The Ugly Duckling to Animal Farm. It follows the adventures of Sprout, a battery hen who flies the coop to pursue her dreams. Befriending a wild duck named Straggler, Sprout faces choices and avoiding a predatory one-eyed weasel. Sprout faces choices between the farmyard and the reservoir, well-fed bondage and dangerous freedom, life and death. Sunmi, in the first pages of your book, your heroine is culled, finds herself in a pit with dead hens stacked on top of her, crushing her bones. It's a very dark tale at times. Characters are maimed and bloodily eaten by predators. Who was your intended readership, and what was your approach to tackling death and darkness in a book which is partly for children?
Ah. 네, 이 작품의 초반부에서부터 매우 어두운 내용이 등장을 합니다. 누군가는 죽고 누군가는 또 끌려나가고 그런 것들이 시작 장면부터 있죠. 저는 어린이를 위해서 글을 쓴다고 생각하지는 않아요. 저는 제가 하고 싶은 이야기를 제가 하고 싶은 방식으로 이야기를 씁니다.
It is true that the book begins in a dark way. A character dies, another character is dragged out. But what I do is I write what I want. I write the stories I want to write in the way I want to write them. So I didn't think I was primarily writing for children with this book.
이 이야기에는 그 어두운 장면이 많이 나오고 물론 어린이 독자들도 읽을 수 있는 책으로 세상에 나오기는 했지만 어린이라고 해서 어렸을 때 죽음을 경험하진 않아요. 어쨌든 어떤 방법으로든 아이들도 죽음이라는 것을 경험하고 슬픔이라는 것을 느끼고 그렇게 성장을 하기 때문에 아주 자연스러운 방법으로 그런 것을 알 수 있게 해주는 하나의 과정을 보여주는 책이라고 저는 생각합니다.
There is lots of darkness in this book, but it's not true that children are completely unaware of such darkness of life. They are aware of darkness and this and sadness, and they learn how to cope with it and grow. And this book shows this process in a very organic way.
Sprout also wants to escape the coop to have her own chick, but her desire to, as she says, do something with her life could be about any personal dreams or ambitions, whether to be a parent or a writer. Do you agree? And how did you feel when the book was seen in Korea, perhaps elsewhere, as being about motherhood and maternal self-sacrifice?
눈에 보이는 이 작품의 설정은 어쨌든 잎사귀라는 이 주인공 캐릭터가 자신의 그 알을 키워보고 싶고 병아리의 탄생을 보고 싶은 그러한 설정이 되어 있습니다.
On the surface, this book, the premise is that Sprout wants to hatch an egg, as you said.
그렇지만 이것은 하나의 상징으로 읽어야 되는 것이고, 잎사귀라는 이 캐릭터의 진정한 어떤 바람이라고 할 수 있는 것은 자신의 마음 속에서 자신을 그 움직이는 어떤 소망 그러한 것을 따라가는 과정의 이야기로서 이 이야기의 그 진정한 그 의도는 인물의 이 캐릭터의 성장에 있다고 볼 수 있습니다. 자신의 소망을 이루어 나가는 과정에서 캐릭터가 성장해 나가는 것에 이 이야기의 목적이 있다고 할 수 있습니다.
But hatching an egg is merely a symbol for what Sprout's dream really is, which is to follow her heart's desire to the fullest extent. And that's what this book is about, how the character grows as she pursues her dreams.
눈에 보이는 설정이 일단 여성의 아이를 그 키워나가는 과정으로 나와 있기 때문에 모성의 이야기인 것처럼 인식이 될 수 있지만 이것은 알이라는 것을 또 자식이라는 것을 인물이 가지고 있는 그 내면의 어떤 소망으로 읽어낼 때는 인물의 성장 이야기라고 충분히 볼 수 있는 거라고.
On the surface, if you just look at hatching an egg, you may think this is a story about motherhood, about raising children. But if you see the egg as a metaphor for your own dreams, this is really a story about character growth.
And in fact, you told me that the hen was in fact modeled on your father. Could you explain a little about that?
Yes, I wrote this story. 저는 매우 우울한 시기였습니다. 내 아버지가 말기암 환자의 상태에서 죽음을 앞두고 있었기 때문에 다른 어떤 것도 할 수가 없었어요. 아버지 걱정 때문에 글을 쓴다는 행위 자체가 저에게는 매우 사치스러운 일이었습니다.
Actually, it was a very difficult time for me when I was writing this book because my father had terminal cancer. So I really didn't have much room in my life for many other things. And to me, writing this book was such a rare opportunity of escape. And it was an extravagance for me, really.
그런데 갑자기 매우 매력적인 소재를 하나 발견하게 됐고, 그것이 저절로 이야기 집을 만들어가는 것 같은 충격을 받았는데, 이야기를 쓰지 않고는 견딜 수가 없을 정도로 매력을 느끼게 됐습니다.
It was at this point when I came up with the idea for the book, and it was such an attractive story to me. The story seemed to tell itself, and I couldn't possibly not write it.
그래서 나는 이 이야기의 주인공을 우리 아버지라고 생각하고 자식이 할 수 있는 가장 좋은 재능으로서 글을 써서 내 아버지의 평범했던 어떤 삶을 기록하고 싶었습니다.
So I think of this book as the model is my father, and as his child, I would like to use my best talents to record his ordinary life into this tale that everybody can read.
It is, as you say, obviously a universal tale of freedom and self-determination, but it can be read as a feminist tale as well, of being trapped in what's expected of you as a woman. Do you agree partly with that? And did you have a difficult path yourself to becoming a writer? And are there still constraints, as you suggested to me, on women writers in Korea?
이 이야기의 주인공의 설정이 일단 여성이고 여성이 자식을 키우는 어떤 그런 과정의 이야기이기 때문에 언뜻 그 여성의 이야기처럼 읽히는 것은 너무나 당연하다고 생각해요.
I think it's only natural that people should assume it's a feminist story because the protagonist is a female character who's trying to raise a child.
그리고 실제로 한국에서 그 어머니의 역할은 자식과 굉장히 그 긴밀한 관계를 유지해 나가고 있고 또 자식을 위해서 어머니가 희생하는 것은 너무나 당연한 것이 한국 사회의 그 문화라고 할 수 있습니다.
And in Korean culture, it's taken for granted that mothers and children have close relationships and mothers will sacrifice everything for their children.
그렇지만 제가 이 책에서, 이 이야기에서 제가 의도했던 것은 그러한 관계 이야기인 것은 아니고 우리가 살아가는데 평범한 사람들이 아주 그 보통의 평범한 사람들이 보여줄 수 있는 평균적인 삶 그러한 것에서 매우 특별한 그런 결단을 내리는 행위 이런 것들을 통해서 아주 특별한 이야기를 하나 만들어냈다고 생각해요.
But my intention was not to focus on that kind of mother-child relationship, but to show how very ordinary people sometimes have to make extraordinary decisions in their ordinary lives.
One theme in the book is also about being special or different. It's about loners against the herd, individualism against conformity. Now, Korean history has arguably left little room for individualism because of fighting Japanese colonialism, military dictators, and pursuing an economic miracle after the Korean War. Do you think Korean society was driven towards certain goals, and that now people are learning a different kind of freedom?
이것은 어디까지나 개인적인 하나의 인물이 자신의 내부의 어떤 욕망을 따라서 움직이는 과정을 보여주고 있기 때문에 매우 개인적인 하나의 이야기로 보여줄 수 있어요.
This is the story of an individual who is pursuing her own individual dream.
그렇지만 문학이 하는 일이라는 것은 아주 큰 거대한 이야기만을 다루어서 그 한 사회를 전체적으로 보여주고자 하는 그러한 것도 있지만 아주 작은 사회를 보여주고 매우 큰 효과를 바라는 그러한 쓰기도 가능하다고 생각합니다.
And while in literature you can have grand narratives that show an entire society or attempt to do so, but you can also have a narrative that shows you a very small picture of a certain part of society, and that can have a very great effect as well.
여기서 주인공을 둘러싸고 있는 하나하나의 그 상황들은 한국 사회에서 충분히 만날 수 있는 하나하나의 군상들의 이미지라고 저는 설정을 했기 때문에 아주 작은 사회를 통해서 우리가 갖고 있는 문제를 보편적으로 보여줄 수 있었다고 생각해요.
And all the situations that Sprout finds herself in, there are situations that people could encounter in Korean society. There are the kind of characters that you could meet in Korea. And so this is a very small part. It's quite just a small part of nature that the book takes place. But it really deals with a universal kind of theme, I think.
You also were born 10 years after the Korean War ended, and you told me that your generation was the last of the baby boom. And that you had a difficult life. You weren't able to finish school. Could you tell me a little about that and your path? As I said before, your path to becoming a writer, how you read what you read, and how you were able to do that.
네, 그렇습니다. 저는 1960년대 한국 전쟁이 끝나고 10년쯤에 태어났죠. 전쟁 뒤에 10년 그 시대는 한국이 어떤 집이든 어려운 모두 다 가난했고 없는 것 투성이의 그런 사회였습니다. 결핍의 세대였어요. 저희 세대는.
Yes, I was born in 10 years after the Korean War, as you said, and in 1960s Korea was a difficult time for everybody living there. Everyone was poor. We were a generation who suffered from deprivation.
정상적으로 단계를 밟아가면서 고등교육을 받는 것이 당연한 일은 절대 아니었습니다.
So it wasn't a given that you would be able to pursue education in the kind of chronological order or higher education.
나도 중학교에 갈 수 없었고 내 친구도 중학교에 갈 수 없었고 공장이나 남의 집에 가서 일을 하는 그런 삶을 선택 없이 받아들여야 하는 때고 그런 때도 있었습니다.
So I was not able to go, and my friend wasn't able to go to middle school either. And there were times when you had no choice but to go work at a factory instead of going to school.
그렇지만 나는 하고 싶은 일이 있었고 나한테 그렇게 부모님이라고 할지라도 나에게 그런 것을 요구하는 것은 부당하다고 생각했기 때문에 끝없이 싸워야만 했습니다.
But I had a dream, and I thought that my parents did not have the right to tell me to do something I didn't want to do, so I continuously fought for my dream.
가출도 해봤고, 대들었고, 싸웠고, 많이 울었습니다.
I ran away from home, I fought with my parents, I cried a lot, and we definitely quarreled a lot.
나는 너무 어렸기 때문에 다시 집에 돌아와야 하기는 했지만, 그렇지만 부모와의 갈등 속에서 화해보다는 갈등을 오랫동안 이어가는 어쩔 수 없는 상황을 받아들이면서 계속 살아야 했죠.
Of course, although I ran away, I was so young, I had to go home quite soon, but we didn't really make up, and there was this conflict for a long time throughout my childhood, and I had to live with that.
어떻게 보면은 잎사귄 저를 아주 많이 닮은 캐릭터라고 할 수 있어요.
So you can say that Sprout has quite a lot of me in her in that way.
And you also have two sons, I believe. In South Korea, education seems to be a very intense process. Children often work until midnight, and mothers are managers of their children's lives. When you meet your young readers in Korea and their parents, what strikes you and what do you tell them and their parents?
네, 한국 사회에서는 어쨌든 많이 가르치고 또 많은 능력을 갖게 하면 어른이 되었을 때 좀 더 좋은 사회에 진입하고 좀 더 좋은 역할을 맡아서 살아갈 수 있을 거라고 생각을 하기 때문에 최선을 다해서 어린 시절에 공부를 가르치고 있습니다.
In Korea, the parents think that the more you teach their children and the more accomplishments they have, the better opportunities they will have in life. So they are very focused on education.
저는 아이들을 학원을 많이 보내지는 못했어요. 부자가 아니었거든요.
But I didn't send my kids to so many private classes because we didn't have the money for it.
분명히 부작용은 있더라고요. 학교에서 시험을 잘 못 봐요.
And they did suffer a bit. They didn't do as well as on their tests as the other children.
그렇지만 그걸 잘못했다고 생각하지는 않습니다.
But I definitely don't think that I made the wrong decision with that.
그래도 잔소리를 잘하는 엄마이기는 했는데 그럴 때마다 아들이 하는 얘기는 엄마가 왜 내 인생 때문에 그렇게 고민하는지 모르겠다. 이렇게 얘기를 합니다.
I was an involved parent, but my son would always say that I don't know why you're so worried about my future. This is my life.
아이들의 자녀 교육 때문에 저와 이야기를 하고 싶어하는 부모님들이 가끔 있습니다.
Parents sometimes want to talk to me about their children's education when I meet them.
그때마다 저는 저도 모범 답안을 가진 학부모는 아니었지만 마음껏 놀게 하라고 얘기를 하고 농사를 꼭 지어보게 해달라고 얘기를 합니다.
And of course, I'm not a perfect parent, but my advice would always be to let them play as much as they want to, let them have the experience of gardening or trying to raise something from the ground.
아이들이 자기가 뿌린 씨앗 하나가 어떻게 변화하는지 느낄 수만 있다면, 보고 깨달을 수만 있다면 그것만큼 좋은 교육은 없다고 생각하기 때문에 그렇습니다.
There's no better education for children, I think. If children can see when they plant a seed and how it grows, if they can realize the implications of that, nothing is better for children than that. Okay.
We're going to be talking tomorrow actually in a seminar about adapting the book into a film. What was your experience of having? What was your experience of having the your book adapted into a film, and also it's becoming so successful? Did it help the book, and how did you feel about that?
소설이 소설로 머무들지 않고 연극이 되거나 영화가 되는 것은 분명히 다양한 독자를 확보하는 아주 좋은 경우라고 할 수 있어요.
When your book becomes a play or a movie, of course you get more readers, and that's a very good thing.
그리고 하나의 그 원소스를 소개하는 좋은 창구가 되는 것도 분명히 맞습니다.
And it is definitely a way of introducing your source material in many different mediums.
실제로 그것 때문에 책이 좀 더 팔린 것도 사실이고요.
And it is true that my sales haven't helped by that.
그렇지만 저는 소설은 소설일 때 가장 아름다운 것 같아요.
But I think that the book is most beautiful in its original form as the book.
그래도 제가 그 영화가 되는 과정에서 간섭을 한 적은 없습니다.
But I didn't meddle in the process of the film adaptation at all.
그 작업을 한 사람은 그 분야의 전문가였고 나는 그를 믿었고 그리고 그는 최선을 다해서 그 작품을 만들었기 때문에 그것은 그가 할 일이라고 생각했습니다.
The person who adapted the film was a professional, so I placed all my trust in him, and he did his best job, and I was very satisfied with it.
Is there a question? There's one there.
Hi there. Is this working? Just hold it closer. I'd just like to know a little bit about your relationship or collaboration with your English translator. That would be interesting.
Ah, 솔직히 말씀드리면 영어로 번역한 사람을 만난 적은 없습니다.
To be honest, I've never met the English translator of the book.
그렇지만 그의 그 번역분이 매우 훌륭했다고 들었습니다.
But I have heard that the translation was quite good.
There's a question.
Hello. I very much enjoyed reading your book. And I just wanted to know.
Could you speak up, please?
I just wanted to know what you're working on now, and also another question: how you get your ideas to write books or short stories, and where do they come from?
지금 작품 어떤 것인지, 그 아이디어 어디서 오시는지 궁금합니다.
저는 그 지금 대형 프로젝트 하나를 진행하고 있는데.
I'm working on a very big project right now, actually.
한국 사회가 안고 있는 문제를 아이들이 이해하기 쉽도록 접근해가는 방식의 책입니다.
It's a book that it's written so children can understand the problems in Korean society, but in a way that children can understand it.
우리나라에는 아주 특수한 지역이 있습니다. 비무장 지대죠.
There's a very unusual place in Korea. That's the demilitarized zone.
그래서 그 첫 번째 이야기를 비무장지대에 관해서 책을 냈고
책을 이미 내셨어요. I've already written a book about the DMZ, actually.
두 번째 작품으로 독도라는 섬에 대한 이야기를 책으로 만들어냈습니다.
And I also wrote a book about an island on the east coast of Korea called 독도.
세 번째는 제주도에 관한 것을 현재 준비하고 있습니다.
And the book I'm writing now is about the island of Jeju, which is in the south of Korea.
그리고 네 번째 예정은 백두산에 관해서 이야기를 준비하고 있습니다.
And the book after that that I'm planning now is about the Mount Baekdu, a mountain in North Korea.
그리고 마지막으로 제가 머물고 있는 한국의 중심 서울에 관한 이야기를 하려고 합니다.
And finally, my book after that is going to be about the city where I live, Seoul.
Okay, I'm afraid we're out of time now. So I'm Maya Jaggi, and I'd just like to thank Sunmi Hwang very much to say she will be signing copies of her book. We may find out where and also to thank the interpreter. Thank you very much, and thank you for coming.
Thank you. Thank you very much.